Hey guys, it's Gemma Forge. Welcome to my channel. I'm so glad you're here. If you're new, I'm Jen, and here we talk about travel, Disney, planning for your next Disney vacation, and today we are going to talk about the Disney dining plan. Now, for my returning subscribers, you know the Disney dining plan is something that I talk about quite frequently. I actually did a video a few months back where I talked about why the dining plan typically does not work for us and why we don't use it. So I want you to go ahead and check out that video if you haven't already. But a few months ago, when I did that video, I started an online discussion with Becca Hart. Now, Becca is a great YouTuber. If you're not following her and if you're not subscribed to her, you want to go ahead and go do that. But I knew that she and her husband had a trip coming up. And I reached out and I said, hey, Becca, I know you guys are using the Disney dining plan. Do you want to do kind of a fun experiment? And what we'll do is, when I get back from my trip, I'll save all my receipts, you guys save all your receipts, and then we'll both do a video about whether or not we felt like we saved money by either doing the dining plan in her case or by not doing the dining plan in my case. She said yes. Now, her trip was not that long ago. In fact, all of her trip vlogs, I think, are up now. Maybe not all of them, but so I've been holding on to my receipts and waiting to do my math. I mean, you guys, these are my receipts from this trip. I literally saved every receipt from every time we ate and added it all up to see, would we have saved money if we had used the Disney dining plan? Now, who was traveling on this trip? Myself and my 22-year-old son. Keep in mind, we do tend to both have at least one drink with dinner, sometimes two. The Disney dining plan, the regular dining plan, does include an alcoholic beverage with both of your meals, and you get a table service meal and a counter service meal per day, plus two snacks and a refillable mug. The deluxe dining plan, and I'm gonna actually look this up while I'm talking to you guys, because the deluxe dining plan, I think, because I know it includes two table service meals. Yeah, and I'm sure it does. I'm sure it includes the, if you want, an alcoholic beverage with each meal as well. But since we don't typically drink with either breakfast or lunch, and we typically have two drinks at dinner, that kind of wouldn't have worked for us. We still would have been out money for dinner. When he had that second beer, I had my second glass of wine. Another thing to note is everywhere we ate, for the most part, we had an appetizer and dessert. For example, the Hollywood Brown Derby, which is actually a signature restaurant, so that would have cost us two dining plan credits. So, without getting ahead of myself, I will go over all of the places we ate and tell you how much we paid for two people for each of those restaurants, because we kind of need to start there. So we spent $30 at Baseline Tap House when we first got to Hollywood Studios. We each had a drink and we shared a pretzel. And then we had a lunch at the 50s Primetime Cafe. That was $78. And all of these numbers include tip. This might help you too if you're going to Walt Disney World to have a realistic idea for how much things cost. We then had dinner at Trattoria Al Forno, where I think we both had two drinks and we did have appetizers. We didn't get dessert, but that bill came to $96.10. The next morning we had brunch at Tusker House at the Animal Kingdom, where we both had a mimosa, and that was $105.66. Then we had dinner that night at the Garden Grill, and we each had two drinks, and that was $143.25. The next day, which was my birthday, way back in July, we had Columbia Harbor House for lunch, and that was $40. And then we had the Hollywood Brown Derby for dinner. Again, that's a signature dining restaurant, so that would have cost us two table service credits, and that was $197.49. For lunch, we had a late lunch the next day at the Kona Cafe. That was $97.29. And for that meal, my son and I both had a sushi roll, which would not have been covered on the dining plan. And also we had, you know, a regular entree. And did we get dessert? I'm not sure if we did. I do know I had sake, and I know that he had a beer. And we went to Top of the World Lounge for a snack that night. And I didn't write down how much that is, but I did put that in my total calculations. And then we went to Tutto Gusto, and we had a wine flight, and we each had a drink. and that was $80. And then we had counter service that day in Japan, and that was $34. So those were all the places that we ate and how much everything was. So I added it all up. And hang on, and I'm gonna tell you if we would have saved money or not if we had done the dining plan. Okay, so do you think you know if we saved money or not? It's kind of exciting. You may wanna go and place a bet with someone, one of your loved ones. See if you can make some money on this proposition. Okay, I'm not advocating gambling. So our total for everything, I went and looked up how much we spent at Top of the World Lounge, and that was $30. So our total for everything. So that was a four-night stay. It was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 table service meals, one of which was a two-credit restaurant. And let's see, two counter service meals, and then the meals that wouldn't have been covered at all. So the baseline Tap House, Tutto Gusto, and Top of the World. And our total for everything with tip was $898.15. Okay, so that's our number. That's how much we spent. But we generally just ate what we wanted without thinking about, for example, the sushi at Kona Cafe. Is this covered on the menu? Because their sushi at Kona Cafe is really good and I really want the sushi. I didn't have to think about any of that, which when I'm on vacation, I don't want to have to choose what I want to eat on the menu. I just want to get what I want to eat. If I want an appetizer as my entree, I want to be able to do that. So that kind of helped me a lot. First of all, the regular dining plan would have cost us $784.79 before tip. But here's why that would not have worked, because you probably heard there were a lot of sit-down restaurants in my list. So the regular dining plan, remember, only covers one sit-down restaurant per day and one quick service meal per day. So we would have spent a lot of money out of pocket on sit-down restaurants, and we would have ended up leaving a lot of credits on the table for the quick service restaurants. So the regular dining plan right away would not have saved us any money at all. Now, the deluxe dining plan would have been more in line with how we ate on this trip. The problem with the deluxe dining plan is it's three meals per day, any combination of counter service and table service. And we really would not have done that many meals. Again, we're not huge eaters. We like to eat more flexibly than that. Flexibly, is that a word? To be more flexible than that. But the deluxe dining plan before tip would have cost us $930. So we still spent less than we would have spent on the deluxe dining plan. And yes, we would have had more food on the deluxe dining plan, but I don't think we would have eaten it. I would not have wanted to eat any more than we did on this trip. I ate plenty. I've been still running, trying to work off my trip from July. So, and then the other thing is, even on the deluxe dining plan, a lot of the things that we ate, like the sushi at Kona, going to Baseline Tap House, going to Top of the World Lounge, those things would not have been covered on the deluxe dining plan. So we were able to have more flexibility. We were able to eat exactly what we wanted. We were able to cancel reservations if we didn't feel like eating, do table service instead of counter service without really having to think about it. And by my calculations, we still came out ahead, because even with the deluxe dining plan, I think we would have ended up not using all of the credits. And so obviously if you don't use it all, then you're wasting that money and we wouldn't have had the same amount of flexibility. So for us, for my son and I, for this trip, the dining plan would not have worked. It would have gotten a thumbs down. We ended up spending less money and having more flexibility by not using the Disney dining plan. I am super excited to see what Becca's research shows, because I know she's got all of her receipts as well, and to see how she made out. And again, it's a little bit tough to tell because you can't just, you have to try to compare apples to apples, because obviously, she and her husband ate within the confines of what the dining plan pays for. So as long as you go into it keeping that in mind, I'm not saying that the dining plan might not be good for your family, but for my son and I, for this trip, the dining plan would not have been a good call and we would not have saved money. And I feel like I would have missed out on some special things that I would have wanted to do. So tell me what you think about my research. Tell me about the dining plan for your family. I know those of you that love it really love it, and I totally get that. Everyone has to do what's right for their family, but I just thought it would be interesting to see after our trip how we came out and if we would have done things any differently. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll subscribe, that you'll hit the bell notification, and that you'll go check out all the other travel, running, and Disney content that I have. Have a great day. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.